Welcome back to the channel, welcome to the video, and in this video, I wanted to see if you could create a website for $5. Yes, that's right. I wanted to see if you could create yourself a website for just $5. Now, when I created this channel, I didn't think very much about the fact that I probably should have a website to go along with it. So along with part of my strategy, I thought recently, I should probably create a blog that shares this content to it as well. And now, as a matter of one, yes, content, and two, time, I thought, is it possible for me to be able to outsource this? And at the same time, could other people benefit from learning just how simple or just how cheap it could be to create a website? So at the end of this video, I hope you can understand if it's possible to be able to create a website and have it designed for you for just $5. So I hopped onto Fiverr and tried to look for some gigs that could help me get there. Now, first of all, I started with WordPress. I thought WordPress is the easiest format. I'm going to be using blogs, so for me, it makes sense to do it in a blog kind of standard way. So I used WordPress, and for that, I created two WordPress sites and then got two gigs on Fiverr to create their best designs they could for just $5. I will have a link to the hosting in the description that I used to create those sites in the first place, and I will also link to the gigs that I used on Fiverr as well. Now, I didn't know exactly what I was gonna get from this gig, because it's $5. I mean, that's less than a coffee at Starbucks. So I wasn't expecting a lot from it, but what I gave them was simple. I gave them a blank WordPress site. I also gave them the title of the website being Real Talk Business, and I created a site header in Canva. And if you haven't used Canva, it's very simple. I use it fairly frequently just to be able to create simple things like this. So I created a simple Real Talk Business header, which is the same one I actually use for my YouTube banner. So I gave them that and said, I want a simple blog that matches this, that has all of my categories done in a certain way. And I want an easy way to be able to populate this. And I haven't seen the outcome of this, but let's have a look. Now, in my selection process, I simply went onto Fiverr and looked for WordPress site creation. I limited it to just $5, so yeah, you know, it's not exactly a large budget here, so manage your expectations and what you get here. But considering you can host a website for about $5 a month, and if you can get a site created for $5, then you're not really spending much. And that's kind of the point I wanted to prove here, that you could really create a website for very little money. So if you want to create something that starts to get you out there and you don't think you have the skills, there are so many different ways you can do it. So if you're a business or just want to monetize your own activities, there are so many ways to do it. And starting with a website from just $5 is an amazing way to do it. So anyway, so on Fiverr, I found a couple of gigs. I gave someone a chance who didn't have a high rating, and I also gave someone a chance who had a bit of a higher rating. But yeah, let's jump in. This is the first time I've seen these. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna jump on and have a look at the WordPress dashboards now. So we have our two dashboards for WordPress. Before I actually look at the sites themselves, you can see these are just the plain backends. So I haven't seen how they've set it up. It looks like this one's used Elementor, and this one hasn't. So the first one, this is gonna be the first site, the first gig I selected. So let's have a look at this one. So this is the homepage they're going for. They use my banner at the top. The button kind of is a bit superfluous, so I don't really need that. They've obviously just used placeholders, which I told them to. They've broken it down by category, which I've told them to. And they have put my social links at the bottom. You know, for $5, I can't complain about that. I don't mind that. I think that's a nice little setup. All right, so we'll go on to the second gig. I'm glad that I checked that out. Okay, so they've gone slightly different. I'm not really sure. I don't like the aspect of that. I think it needs to be spread out more, and it could be full full page. I mean, I've got a fairly wide monitor, so maybe it will appear a bit better. But this looks a bit, I don't know, this looks a bit aging to me. So I like the way that they've done the split. These are all the categories that I have on my YouTube channel. And so they've split the content down by that. I quite like the way that they've done that. I like the sections, but the top section here, I do like the fact that they've got some trending things, so I can put other content on the top here, but it looks a bit clunky. I'm not a big fan of how the social lines up. For me, that should line up a bit lower. And this, I'm not really a big fan of having these here either. I'd kind of get rid of them in total and have just more links down the side there maybe. But what I'm saying is right now is I'm nitpicking because they did this for $5. Like $5, come on man, that's genuinely, it's less than a sandwich in most places. I can't buy a sandwich over here for less than $5. It's crazy. So I'm suitably impressed, but I'd love to know what you guys think. What would you think about these two different sites? Which one do you think I should go for? I haven't picked. I can make some further changes to these, but out of the two, which ones would you pick? Would you pick number one or number two? Number two or number one? Which one would you pick? I'd be really interested to know. And like I said at the beginning, the main point of this for me was that everyone that wants to try and monetize a certain aspect of their life, the biggest advice I would give to, and I give to my kids now, is find your passion and try and monetize it. And if you're trying to monetize it, you will need a site. And everyone says, I can't do this, I can't do this. But it's so simple now to create your own website. Even if you want a basic website, you don't have to pay the world. Like, you could set these things up yourself, but if you don't think you can, instead of buying that Starbucks coffee, get someone to do it for you. You won't have the most perfect website in the world, but it will be a start, and then you can start building on that and making it better each time. But there are no excuses for anyone thinking about starting a business and thinking about just monetizing their passion to not have a website. So if you want to start a website, check out Fiverr in my links below. You, like I said, you can't give too much stick for the $5 spends. I think they did a great job for the budget. You've got to value people's time. So the fact that they could even do this, a lot of this includes the use of more pro plugins as well. So I have to say, I am suitably impressed. I didn't think that they would do much at all for $5. So I am impressed that they've managed to do this and be able to use some of those pro features that I can then utilize. So thanks very much to the guys in the gigs, much appreciated. If you want to use either my web hosting or my Fiverr links in the description, go and check those out. Get yourself a website today and start monetizing your passion or your business. Thanks again for watching. If you like these sorts of videos or anything related to this, don't forget to drop me a comment, subscribe, and let me know what you think. Anyway, I'll see you on the next one. Peace.